Good morning, Godly Women Win community and everyone else watching the replay. I'm so happy to have you here. And again, thanks to Pastor B. Cassandra for this opportunity. It's been so much fun. So say hello when you hop on, or say replay if you're watching the replay. I'd love to see who's there. Also, if you have any comments or any questions during the broadcast or after, make sure you put them in the comments and I will either address them while I'm live if I can, or I will just circle back and reply to you later, I promise. So today we are talking about simplifying our priorities. And much like our goals, which I talked about last week, we tend to have too many priorities. We say that our families are our priority, that our health is our priority, that our businesses are our priority, that our faith is our priority, that any other number of things are our priorities. But guys, when we have so many things that we're calling priorities, it kind of means that none of them are our priorities, right? If we're trying to pursue too many things, we're dividing our efforts and really minimizing our impact in all of those areas because we're trying to go wide instead of deep. So if we actually want to prioritize things in our life, we have to understand what priority means. It means that certain things are more important than others. It means that if you're faced with a decision between spending more time with your family and working on another project for your business that might make you some more money, you have to decide which one you're going to invest in right now. It means trying to decide between getting a little bit more sleep and working out in the morning. It means making a lot of decisions between good things. The options are generally good, right? We don't have a really hard time making decisions about a good option and a bad option. It's usually between things that we really want to do. So we need to figure out what our priorities are. And I always advocate for making a prioritized or like hierarchical list of our priorities. So you can say that your faith is your priority. You can say that your family is your priority, that your business is your priority. But out of the things that you're trying to prioritize, what of those priorities is your number one priority? So if you have five priorities, I want you to put them in order. I don't want you to weigh them out equally. I want you to say that my number one priority is my relationship with God. My number two priority is my relationship with my people, like my close family, my close friends, my significant other, my spouse, whatever that means to you, and define it. My number three priority is my business, or for me, my health. And then my number four priority is my business and what that means and what kind of circle that is and how big that goes. And then my number five priority is people outside of that and social media and things that fall into that category. Put them in order. And then structure your schedule and your day and your calendar around that. Create pockets of time that are dedicated to those things in that order, so that you know if you're trying to make a decision between something for your family and something for your business, that family comes first. And it's much easier to make those decisions when you have put those priorities in place and told other people. Other people and other commitments need to know where they stand. You have to set boundaries on things. And so I want you to put your list of priorities in order. And don't be afraid to write them down, to post them, to tell other people when it affects them. I mean, you don't have to like post it on social media, like, these are my priorities, and you fall within category five, or you didn't even make it on the list. But I'm saying if you're trying to negotiate some boundaries with a client, let them know that you're only responding to emails between 9 and 5 because your business is not your number one priority. Your time with your family is, and that means you need to be present in the morning with them. And that means that you need to be present for dinner and bath time and reading or movie nights or whatever it is that you do. Carve out specific chunks of time for things, dedicating as much time as you can to the things that are your priorities. Because if you say that you're prioritizing certain things, but you don't actually follow through in terms of how you schedule yourself, then it's just words and it doesn't really mean anything. So decide what your priorities are, put them in order, and then put them on your calendar. Carve out time, follow through, have your life reflect the list of priorities that you're declaring, and having them declared, having them written down in a place where you can revisit them is really going to help you follow through with that. So I hope that helps you guys today. I hope that helps you set your priorities and set some boundaries and have some really good conversations with the people in your life about how you can do that and how you can set collective priorities for your business, for your family, for your community, whatever that looks like for you. And I would love to hear what your priorities are. So comment below with your priorities, ask any questions that you might have. If you want to chat about it further, we can definitely do that too. I always love talking with you and just chatting about how we can simplify everything to make our lives easier and do more of what we love and less of what we don't. Okay, that's it for today, you guys. Have a wonderful day, and I will talk to you again soon. Bye.